fungus, dandelion leaves, just simple, pure dandelion leaves. I'm just gathering them for my salad. They are before blooming, they haven't bloomed yet. They are pretty rich in calcium, which is of course great for your bones and teeth. And they have ability to reduce high cholesterol, and they might help you to lower high blood pressure as well. I just love them in salad. Of course, they are great for many things, not just salad. But the best way to avail, as what I think is, to profit from their fresh state, as fresh as possible. So I wouldn't really kill them by cooking them or boiling them, because their healing sap and chlorophyll is in presence when they're fresh. So the best way would be, I would say, salad. Of course, I like making tea or light decoction with its root. So I will be digging some root as well shortly. And the best way, or the best time to dig the root, is to do so in very early spring or late fall. There is one root I just dug. So I will wash it, I will chop it, smash it perfectly so all minerals and essential oils can release, while I'll be doing light decoction. So I'll be simmering it lightly in the water with few of the leaves, probably some stinging nettle and some roots of the nettles, like for 10 or max 15 minutes. Then I'll let it steep in the water and I'll drink it. It's great for everything, for your kidneys, for your liver, for all your inner organs. And as you probably read on the abilities or properties and benefits of the dandelion root, it can help to stop growth of cancer cells. It might help to actually combat cancer, as the recent studies made over and over showed. So that's the dandelion root that I'll be on later, or not now, but I'm on the leaves now. As I probably said, they are rich in calcium and great for your kidneys for its diuretic properties. So they work great for kidneys. They increase urine production and detox. They have abilities to detox toxins from your body and promote your liver. So dandelion leaves, and especially root, is very good for your liver, for your sluggish liver. What I do is I do tincture from leaves and from roots, which helps to promote your liver, and for hangovers as well, if somebody might suffer from, but generally for good health. As I said, the best way to avail of its benefits is the raw way, fresh way, to eat them fresh. So I'll mix them with what I have at home. So I have some grapefruit, so I'll make salad with just dandelion leaves and grapefruit, some mountain vinegar, some spruce tip oil or rosehip oil, probably some little bit of seaweed or some wild seeds that I have. Or you can use whatever you like, whatever you have on your hand, but I like simplicity. I like actually to combine them with wild garlic, or you can use onions. There are special elements in these leaves that are able, they have ability to remove toxins from your body and slow down cancer cells to develop while preventing it from spreading it. So I think it's a great ability, and thanks to antioxidant and phytonutrients that are in the presence of these leaves and the roots, it's got this ability to combat the cancer fight. It's a they are great fighters, those phytonutrients and those antioxidants, fighters of cancer cells. It's also great remedy actually for diabetic people, as I learned, especially the root. So I would really recommend it for diabetes as well. Actually, every part of the dandelion, plant is healing, is medicinal, and is edible. So not just medicinal, but also edible. Root, leaves, little blooms before they go in flower. You can pickle them in interesting brine, or then flowers when they're blooming. You can fry them, or you can use them raw in the salad. So the whole plant is medicinal and edible. I think it's one the most interesting plant in the botany, as for myself. I'm just trying to think what I'm doing with, normally what I do with these leaves is, like today I will eat them fresh. I will try the rest of them. Usually I gather them when it's not rainy, so I can dry them easily. So those ones I might just eat in salad. But I like to make decoction, tea decoction as I said. And I also like to dry them for later reference. Especially blooms for salves and roots for myself, for creams and salves. And I like to use them as the part of my raw crackers. And I treat them like the greens while cooking or while making salads. I love to make smoothie. It's great to juice them as well. That's what I would recommend for any cancer patient, to juice them or to make smoothie. But the better way would be to juice them. And yeah, I love to have them in my diet because I feel that they really kill the pain with their ability they have. So simple plant, so strongly medicinal. I still don't see the point why people keep killing it. So yes, that's my favorite plant.